Nobody wants to get united. Like, what we gotta do is meet everybody at 149th Street at the bench.
Today's video might be a little bit controversial, and I definitely want your guys' thoughts on it in the comments down below. Let me know what you guys think about this topic. I want to talk to you guys about the title of king and who it gets bestowed on. So I think this conversation should really be starting with, what's a writer? A question that some newer graffiti artists may not know. So in case you're new to graffiti and you're not aware, a writer is somebody who does graffiti illegally, as to where a graffiti artist is somebody who just does graffiti. And as a result, every writer is a graffiti artist, but not every graffiti artist is a writer. Once again, the distinction being, a writer does graffiti illegally, and you have to be a writer in order to be a king. You can't only do murals in legal walls and expect to ever be a king. Putting a crown on your hand style, a writing king next to your name, it's something that you put in the work for, it's something that you earn. And this is a title that's gonna require you in order to get up in a large amount of area. And we're not just talking a couple of tags every so blocks. And that's why this is so difficult, because in order to be a king in a larger city, you have to do an ungodly amount of work. And that's where the title matters. That's where the respect comes from. And this is a title that has to be bestowed on you. This is not something you call yourself because you like the way it sounds, you like the way the crown looks on your hairstyle. This is something that you gain the respect of everyone in your community, and they recognize you as being a king because you did that much work. So unless you want to be the Joffrey of graffiti, you should not be putting a crown on your hairstyle, or anything for that matter. Now, before social media, you had people who would call themselves king, and they really weren't. They'd throw a crown on their hairstyle and they didn't put up enough work, or they were just whack to begin with all of like 2 years of graffiti under their belt. But nowadays, especially with social media, you see a lot of people getting called king who don't really deserve it. And once again, that's not necessarily the fault of the person making the artwork. But what is the fault of the person making the artwork is when they call themselves a king, especially when they don't get up. Just as some reference, I've known graffiti artists personally who have been doing graffiti longer than I've been alive. Like, these are my friends. And not a single one of them would dare put a crown on their handstall if they don't already have it. Why? Because, well, they didn't put in enough work in order to deserve it. It takes an immense amount of work in order to get to that status. And to have some kid who just started doing graffiti, or to have anybody who didn't earn it go ahead and throw a crown on their handstall or any of their work, is a massive sign of disrespect. And when it's some kid who just started doing graffiti, that's an innocent mistake. Once you tell them what the deal is, you'll find, usually more times than not, they stop putting the crown on their handstall or their other work. But when you have somebody with experience in the game and they definitely didn't deserve it, or they only do legal walls, and you see them start to rock crowns or call themselves king, that's just ridiculous. That's silly, and they are essentially a toy for that. And if you're seen putting this on your work before you've actually earned it, this is something that can end up losing you any of respect that you might have already had. Because now that you have that on your work, people are gonna look at your work with a certain type of scrutiny, the harshest kind of judgment, in order to see whether or not you're actually worthy of that crown. Because there's more to just getting up in order to be a king. Because like I said before, you have to actually hold down a large amount of area. But more than that, you have to have the years under your belt, and you have to have the skills to back it up. And now this brings us to the title of legends, because we see a lot of people call just random graffiti artists a legend. I can't tell you guys how many times in my DMs I have somebody tell me, "Hey John, I got a legend in my town who's mentoring me." Well, if it's a legend in your town specifically, then spoiler alert, they're not a legend. And the reason for that is because legends are world renowned. Legends are people who have changed the face of graffiti on a global scale. Those are the real legends. And this is something legal graffiti artists can do. This is something that any graffiti artist can do. While sure, you have people like JA and Saber, they became legends because of their illegal graffiti and their notoriety that came with it. You also have legal only graffiti artists who've reached the same legendary status because they made such an impactful style, everybody globally tried to copy them. And as a result, they've influenced graffiti and its aesthetic on, once again, a global scale. While you may at first think, with social media, you can affect the global scale really easily, this isn't necessarily the case. Well, yeah, you sure can have a bunch of people globally see your work to influence graffiti on a global scale, to where people off of social media are still trying to do what you do or to understand what you've put out there. That's different than just simply making content and then people see it globally. This is also the reason a lot of old school graffiti artists are graffiti legends, despite the fact that not a lot of people know all of these people's names. And the reason is because they're the forefathers of graffiti. Without them, we wouldn't even have graffiti. So it's safe to say they affected graffiti on a global scale. And while not all of them are credited for this, the notable ones are. Alright, I think that pretty much wraps up today's video. Let me know what you guys think about it in the comments down below. What are your thoughts on this topic? If you enjoyed today's video, remember to hit the like button. It helps out a bunch. And if you're new here, feel free to join the smartest graffiti community anywhere online. We have the best how to do graffiti tutorials you can possibly find. If you want some more graffiti content, feel free to click any of these videos on the side of your screen. And I'll catch you guys next week. As always, I want to thank you guys for watching. I really do appreciate it. Until next time, peace.